Meanwhile, the state government has vowed to crack down on hoons who prompt police chases. Runaways can expect jail time under tough new laws.
As if on cue, a dangerous driver leads police on pursuit through Wantirna, running red lights and eventually crashing into a car carrying seven people. And all this on the day new laws are unveiled to crack down on runaway drivers.
You cannot have people breaking the law with impunity and doing a runner and expect that they can just get away with it.
Under beefed up legislation, those who lead police on pursuit face 3 years in jail as well as a 12-month licence suspension.
Toro police members come to work each day and the last thing they want to engage in is a police pursuit. It is high risk.
Gail Kinsella welcomes the tough stance. She'd only had her car 2 days when it was hit by a driver fleeing a police roadblock in August.
If it deters five people, that's a good thing.
In the past 10 years, pursuits have risen from 545 to more than 700 last year. The Police Association pushed hard for the reform, with a variety of offences sparking recent chases.
And it could be as minor as they don't have a driver's licence to as serious as they have a body in the boot.
The new penalties don't include a minimum mandatory period of imprisonment. The police minister says that's a matter for the courts to decide.
3 years is good. I mean, nobody wants to do 3 years, do they, in prison?
The laws will be passed this year. David Woywood, 10 News.